All right. Hello, soldiers. I didn't do anything wrong.
Long live Excel.
And all the easy to find witches already, and I could use them quickly.
One little bone I had.
How much for a herring?
Proud to have all walked a crooked path.
Man, I had to kill my dwarf friend, that sucked.
I'm all ears, witcher.
Got something for you.
I love gifts, but I prefer to unwrap them in private. Oi, lads, mind the barrels. Going out for a jabber with Geralt. Come. Oh, that's better. All right, what do you have for me?
Max Bersodi's house, as requested.
Must be livid.
He's not.
No.
He's not anything except dead. His brother, same thing. A few others, too.
Stones you've got. But I didn't think you'd have the stomach for a massive one.
Situation got out of hand.
Oh, sounds familiar. There you are, drinking, puffing on henbane, and then, surprise, heads rolling across the floor. And none know how or why.
I'm not amused.
No. Why not?
Cause unlike you, killing gives me no pleasure.
The Borsodis aren't worth your tears. Sons of bitches to a man.
Alright.
Why did you need those papers?
To sink the Borsodis, naturally. You see, I learned of an interesting clause in old man Maximilian's will. It states that his sons must meet and shake hands in agreement at least once a year at Bellatay. Failing that, the auction house must be auctioned off. The proceeds to go to Vilmarius Hospital.
Guess the old man sensed what might happen.
Horst and Yuld are gnawing on soil now. But thanks to these papers, their relatives won't get the auction house. Family's lost it for good. And the hospital will have the funds it needs to treat orphans and beggars pro bono.
Awfully Wait. Noble of you.
That is very noble.
So much concern for the needy.
I couldn't give a rat's arse about the needy. May they wither and disappear along with the city. I wanted one thing. Revenge.
The Borsodis. What's your gripe? Get kicked out of an auction?
Worse. They evicted me from my home. Are you really interested?
Sure.
Wouldn't have asked if I wasn't.
Ha! Cheeky as ever. My family, they took on some debt. A poor investment in a sawmill. A bad crop one year. A lawsuit lost. You know how it is. When it rains, it pours. We needed but a few weeks to recover. But Horst Borsodi had acquired our debt. All of it. Demanded it be repaid immediately. I pleaded. I begged. I tore open my shirt at his threshold. Ugh. It was like talking to a wall. I went to the auction. Saw those perfumed pricks by my father's sword. My mother's death mask. My brother's horse tack. Ah, Horst earned a pretty pile selling our mementos.
No surprise the animosity you feel for him.
That was but the start. My Iris's parents learned of my family's misfortune. And our betrothal was no more. They found her another suitor. One from beyond the sea. The anger I felt. I thought I'd gone mad. Went to the tavern. Drank a round. A second. Abroad. Then had another tanker. And then... Then, I asked the wrong bloke for help.
What happened then?
What happened then, Witcher, was one big stinking pile of shite. Well, why do you stand there? Do you need something still?
Yeah, I need the third request.
Third wish. Time you stated it.
A moment, Geralt. I will say to something. Then we'll chat. You there. Yak the heron out the barrel.
Alright, I'm not surprised.
Come on, none of this dallying.
Now, ready to listen? Or do you still not give two shits about what I've got to say?
I'm ready. I'm listening.
Good. You'll return to your lord and tell him as follows. His demand was brazen. Hurt me to the core. For I was brought up to respect the sacred law of hospitality. And I shall not bend to an uncouth boor's dictum. Understood? I will pay him a visit shortly to test his willingness to adapt. So you ride off and announce me. And don't spare your horse. Got it?
Aye, got it.
Give this man a mount and leave him go. Come with you. We must talk outside.
Sure thing.
Theferi believe one should only discuss important matters out of doors, with the gods as witnesses.
Beryl, what was that about?
On the way here, we stopped for nourishment at a tavern belonging to one Lord Dauntless. We enjoyed ourselves as one does at an inn, raucously. Our antics were not to the liking of this Dauntless. Sent a man to warn us that if we were ever to return, we would hang.
You burned the inn down?
I left ample compensation with the innkeep. But it seems the rapscallion neglected to mention this to his lord. But that's of little import. What matters is someone called me a whoreson and threatened to kill me.
Ah.
It was one of those threats that sound like an invitation. I intend to accept it. Return to those parts.
Okay. I don't think there's any need to say that.
Fulfilled two of your wishes. Time I learned the third.
Confident, aren't you? Proud, sure of your strengths. Fearless.
Third task, if you don't mind.
Mutations. They stripped you of emotion. Tell me, have you ever loved? I mean, truly loved.
Sure.
Yeah, I've loved. Can we get to the matter at hand?
Perhaps instead we ought to sit down inside. Have a good chat over some fiery water.
You know what? Sure, man. After this is done.
We'll drink once the job's done.
I'm afraid that's impossible. Succeed, and that's the end of me. Fail, and you'll not be back.
Third wish. Still waiting to hear it.
Why? Aren't you stubborn? Fine. Listen well. I had a wife once. The day I saw her last, I gave her a rose. A violet one. Bring me that blue. Wouldn't mind reminding myself what it looks like.
When was that? How long's it been? Flowers wilted and turned to dust by now.
You wished to hear a wish. Now you have. Fulfill it. I ride now to visit this Dauntless, but one of my men will remain here. He'll know how to find me. That is, of course, should you succeed.
At least you could tell me where your wife is.
In my old manor, east of Martin Foy's farmstead. I'd wish you godspeed, but, well, you understand, I'm sure.
So
goodbye, Geralt.
Oh boy, how am I gonna raise a fucking flower from the dead? Like, what? Okay. Oh, pardon me, Witch Hunter. Yeah, so now our flower is going to possess us. We're going to take it to a wedding. It's going to want to get all crazy. Necromancy so we can make a zombie flower? Oh my god, look at that. Weather effects in this game is so good! So good. Roach! You have to resurrect a flower, my friend.
Let's go!
Whoop!
Slow now. Come on. Go, go.
Mighty rusty and covered in creepers. Need another way in.
Not so fast, Roach.
Kendrick? Kendrick? You there?
Not so loud.
Ah!
Hello, Hoy?
Scared me off to...
Not so loud, I said. Fog's not natural. Could be something in there hiding. Foglets or air nymphs, for example. Don't want to attract them, believe me.
Foglets? Oh, sweet mother Melitely, why did I ever come here?
Good question.
Good question. What are you doing here?
See, Kendrick and me, we thought man has been empty all these years, full of fine things going to rot.
So you're a thief?
Thief, steal from the living. What's the arm taken from the dead? Kendrick went to open the door. I stood watch. Suddenly heard his lamp smash. Then nothing. Quiet. Called out to him, but... What was that? One of them foglets you spoke of?
No.
Phew. That's a stone off my...
I'll see what that was and look for your partner. You...
Ain't about to wait around. I'm out of here.
Pretty sprawling, this estate. How am I gonna find that rose in this fog? Fresh manure.
Fresh would mean someone's living here.
Water's ice cold. Mountain stream cold. Rather worn. Used often. Wonder by who?
Is that just a dog hanging out?
A grave here?
Ruff, ruff, puppy!
What are you doing in a place like this? Best shoe before you get hurt.
Little puppy?
Someone's still tending to the flower beds. No violet rose, though. Woods rotted completely.
All right.
Beehives. Well maintained, but dormant. No violet rose here. Maybe somewhere out back.
Now a black cat.
I'd scooch along, kitty. This place. What's that? That digging?
Hold on. Is the option to go up here still available? Do I watch anime? Yeah. Sums up with these pets.
Must have been the other thieves.
Yeah, must have been.
Prints from cleated boots, leading from the back of the garden. Someone dragged a wounded man through here.
Mm-hmm. How about we just go in here?
Graves, unmarked, laid out in rows like garden beds.
Hey. Hear me?
Another thief. Body's mutilated.
Who are you?
What the fuck?
Damn.
What in the hell? Oh shit. Did he just dispel? Sorry, did you just absorb my health? Alright, Dark Souls boss. This is gonna take a long time, but I think we got this. This boss is nothing compared to some Dark Souls bosses. Mm-hmm. I... see the problem here. Well, that's not fair. This guy's not bad. Oh, that is annoying. Nothing special. And now you're dead. Thank you for playing, Caretaker. Get fucked. Wait, whoa. Wait a minute. Okay. Problem.
What the fuck was that?
For real though, what the fuck was
that? No eyes or nostrils, deformed organs. Damn thing had no right to be alive.
Oh, you want to fight now too, Cat? Come on, bring it.
Well, philosophers do still debate what it means to be alive, exactly.
Yeah, alright, sure.
Normally I'd be shocked, but not after what I just saw. Who are you two?
Clearly not animals. Think of us as friends of the house.
All right.
What's with the show? The pretense that you're animals. You couldn't have warned me?
No. We're obliged to maintain discretion.
So why talk to me at all?
Why? Well, we get so few chances to talk to humans, and we're curious to know what brought you.
Gonna need a better answer than that.
Later.
Alright.
What about this thing? What can you tell me? Friend of yours?
We called him the Caretaker.
Doesn't look like any creature I've ever seen. Where'd it come from?
From very far away. He was summoned to guard Lady Iris and the home. He tended the garden, took care of unwanted guests.
Very far away, meaning where exactly?
The name of this place would mean naught to you.
Alright, that's an answer, I guess.
You know the master of the house, the owner?
Olgierd von Everick. Yes, we know him, but he left, and his wife became mistress of the house.
Great. So, Lady von Everick home? Could you announce me, say she has a guest?
Why do you wish to see her?
I'm here to get the violet rose Olgierd gave Iris just before he left.
Iris is inside, in the bedchamber upstairs. Take his key. It opens the rear door.
Guess I'll make my own introductions.
Interesting.
So, how should I address you?
As you did now. We'd rather keep our names to ourselves.
I just killed the butler? I guess I did. It was a pretty powerful butler, though.
You will die.
Well, is that any way to treat a guest? This place, looks like it's maybe seen better days. Have I watched the first episode of Castlevania? Yeah, I've seen it. It was pretty cool. I did just murder her butler? I guess that's true. I did just murder her butler. Alright, that painting's a little weird. Just gonna put that out there.
What the hell?
Well...
gotta be careful.
Yeah, you think? Ah, damn it. Overburdened. Ooh. Upgraded sword.
What the hell was that?
Be gone.
Olgierd as I've never known him. A different man then.
We need to call the Ghostbusters here.
Tidy, and everything's clean, ready for a meal to be served. Caretaker must still set the table.
I am possessed? The professor is possessed? Oh, okay, this is just how we're playing this game now. Well, okay. I guess, this house is really haunted. It's haunting my legs. Well, okay, we'll just casually walk over here, I guess. And let's go upstairs. You didn't know we were magical, did you? You can't stop me, I'm the professor, sucker. No barriers can stop me now. Wow, yeah, something's really fucked up. Like, even jumping doesn't get me out of this, whatever the hell this is. Oh boy.
damage. Interesting.
F this painting. This is really weird.
Happy families are all alike. Every unhappy family is unhappy in its own way.
Nice, so where do I go? Locked. Locked. This is really just... Come on, game. Oh, maybe we jump out of the window. Where the hell? There's nowhere else to go down here, is there? Oh, I guess there's a side stair. Can we go up here? Nope. I mean, do we want to fix this? Actually, yeah, I kind of want to fix it. It was funny for once, but... We've had our fun. That was a really cool bug. So the ghost pushed the chair, I think, like through our body, which then bugged us out. Huh. There we go. We got our legs back. All right, so where the hell am I going? Can I open these doors now that I'm not bugged? Looked at the painting. We can't go outside. Oh wait, maybe we can arb? How am I supposed to go? We can't climb out the window. This is the only open door. It's gotta be through here. Oh, it's right here, Jesus. Okay. Ah, yeah, that's perfectly normal. Do you think you have any chance? I will say, you are fast though. Oh, this is a cool fight. Look at the... Jesus, you are persistent. Ma'am, I would appreciate it. I thought I had Quinn up. No, I want to hit the painting. Force this. Place is on fire. Lit as hell.
Bedchamber. Iris was supposed to be here.
Yeah, I think Iris is here, buddy. We'll get to you in a moment. I don't think you're going anywhere.
Lovely couple.
These robes, though. Holy shit.
Gotta be her. Damn it.
You wish to see her? Here she is.
A man should frame his wishes carefully. It forestalls disappointment.
This some sick joke. Why didn't you tell me she was dead right away?
You didn't ask.
And why hasn't anyone buried her?
We can't. As for the caretaker, the one you cut down, while still alive, she ordered him to stay away from her for all time.
Well, shit.
How did she die? Don't see any wounds, evidence of a fight.
Her heart burst.
Meaning what? A heart attack?
No. It simply burst.
find that hard to believe.
Yet that's precisely what happened. One day, Iris locked the front door, lay down here and died. From grief, from loneliness.
The deeper I get into this, the more I gotta wonder. Why are you even helping me?
We were summoned to serve Iris von Everick. Our mistress died, but that did not free us from her service.
Got it. You want to leave this place, leave these bodies.
Surprised?
No, not at all. Her ghost's restless, angry, attacks intruders. Know why?
Lady von Everick has endured much hardship. She's unaccustomed to guests and not fond of strange folk.
She can't hear us.
Seems I gotta speak to Iris's ghost.
It's no easy task to contact the mistress. Rage and bitterness fill her.
Got my ways. To make contact with Iris, I gotta bury her body. But that caretaker's macabre little cemetery won't do. Too much blood, too much fear.
She spent much time in the front garden.
Maybe there.
Wait. Take this key. It opens the front door.
Good dog.
Sure, that pissed it off. Not over there. Cartwheel, please.
Iris von Everick adored flowers.
But she would never want to destroy them.
All right. I'll dig the grave somewhere else. This place seems suitable.
Yes, she loved to paint.
Did Iris von Everick have any last requests? Say how she wanted her remains disposed of?
She feared death. Worried none would see to her burial or say a kind word in parting.
Guess I'll be the one to do that.
Yeah, if she's the one who painted all those. So sure.
Can't say much about Iris von Everick, but I do know I like her paintings. It's a shame her art couldn't bring her greater comfort. At times, fate muddles our path, and life turns toilsome, hard to bear. Yet all deserve respite and peace in death. I don't know if you want to be buried with a painting of your husband, but you live together, so maybe you want to be with him in death as well. You two, got any last words for your mistress?
We don't partake in human rituals.
Trusting that what you've done is in keeping with your customs.
All right.
The remains are interred. Let's summon her. Tormented spirit, I've laid your bones to rest. Forget your wrath, forget your grief. Show yourself.
Whoa.
Forgive me for tearing you from your realm. I need to ask you. Should I follow you? All right.
Yeah, all right, let's walk into a painting. This really is Dark Souls.